Good afternoon, everyone, and welcome to the Big Fat Stop Show. Stop. It's the Big Fox, y'all. Welcome to the talk show. So with me this afternoon is my two beautiful co-hosts. Well, let me introduce myself first. My name is Neville O'Connor, all the way from the West, and T-Ways. Today with me are my two beautiful co-hosts. On my left is Abusadi, and on my right is Venetia. Let's go straight into it. Today we'll be looking at parental and sexual consent. This is a topic many young people or persons that I know don't like to talk about. So let us get into it.
Alright, so it says here that parental consent is a parent's right to give consent or be informed before their minor child undergoes any kind of medical treatment, any kind of activity whatsoever.
This is funny. Your parents gotta sign something for you gonna do something. I remember going to school, many times when I get this slip for your parents signing for go on tour, I sign it myself and I'll give it to the
teacher. Okay. Yeah, I'm kind of ready. I'm not kind of ready at that. But, this thing with parental consent, right? It's like, I don't really, it's like a norm, if it's a social to say. Cause like, it's not something that people really like acknowledge, like it's not like a rule or law, but you know to yourself that, you know, there's something that is mandatory or something, you know, as a child, as a teenager, or sometimes even in your big adult age. Do you think so?
No, I doubt it.
You doubt it?
I can remember clearly I was like 17 or 15 somewhere around there, and I asked to go somewhere. My mom said no, I get to be and win some. I see it as no big.
You see now, you different.
True.
You different. There's a difference between females and males.
Yeah, we can't change certain
times. Oh, though some of them try.
But in the Caribbean, right, when if a parent say you gotta wear red, you can't tell them you're wearing red. That consider parental consent too. They're supposed to be, you know, have this communication with that child.
To me, it don't really sound like consent. It sounds like them just telling you what to do.
Okay. So what is your take on this, Miss Abusadi?
I'm not. It depends on how you look at it. Like for me, if you look at it from the child's perspective where, you know, well, a parent invading your privacy, they don't ask you certain questions, they just, you know, they take it upon themselves. I make you, especially for my parents, I make you to whatever I say so. Then, now, on the other hand, with a parent giving you permission to do certain things, it's deemed as how good of a child you are thing. How you
got
permission to do this or you have permission to do that.
Yeah, I totally agree with that. Yeah, I see with y'all, but I little know what you're saying to me with you.
Okay, so one of the responses we got from our Instagram was that parental consent is paramount to ensure safety. It's like, it's something like them knowing where you are or allowing you to go somewhere, or they will do so based on the fact that they want you to be safe, right? So this person is saying, in my view, it's a win-win situation for both parent and child when there's a good relationship between them. Emphasis on good relationship. When the parent can withhold consent and the child understands because he or she knows the parent will only do so because they have their best interests at heart. Withholding consent should not be because of lack of trust or to exercise control. Which in, I think most times is be because they want to control you.
You live in under my roof, you can do as I say.
Exactly. Exactly like what I'm saying earlier.
So now we go straight into sexual consent.
This is a broad. This is a big.
I need to stand and take a sip for this because.
This is a big one.
Getting sexual in this lifetime, no. Can't say this like in this generation.
Yeah.
Because I may be looking at you in a certain way, you think I'm looking at you in a certain way.
True.
Let us just get into it.
Okay, so sexual consent. That is consent to engage in sexual activity. That's basically what it is, right? So.
Yeah, I'm sexual activity as in sexual intercourse or just.
Intercourse.
Dry humping.
Anything.
Yeah, consent to
anything sexual. Okay, sexual so. Activity.
So you tell me at a party, see this girl I like. I buy drinks with she all night. But I gotta get consent for going wine on she.
Yes,
so why are you drinking my drink?
Nobody, because you chose to give me the. Exactly, you chose to buy me drinks. I didn't ask you. Did I ask for you? Nobody told you. To show off your pocket.
Alright. Next question, just with two ladies, right?
Okay.
This is a case y'all married. Y'all husband not working, no way. He being home all day laying around, you know what I mean? Playing game. Watching sports, hanging with the boys. Y'all got your 9 to 5. Mm-hmm. Y'all go to work, come back now. So again this night, y'all come home tired. Champion clean the house. Champion get no meal cook. Champion do nothing but champ just lay in the back door, sit on a chair, watching football or basketball or something. Mm-hmm. However, you know Miss Cinderella clean the place. Go and make breakfast for both of y'all, or dinner, or whatever time it is. Then when y'all go to bed, champ wants to have sex. But you tired. No, you're tired. You say no all the time. Mm-hmm. You say no, but he wants to have sex. You don't give him consent, but he end up and force himself onto you. Is that considered rape?
Well, you see, the key word there, right, is force.
Can you stop, Joe?
I see. When you came in here with your sex, is your husband?
No. Yeah, but that don't give him the right. Not a guy, somebody's husband, meaning whatever. You ready to do something, they got ready to do it as well, or else, you know? It's just like if a stranger, or not even a stranger, because they got people in your family that do it, right? Good. So it's just like if you have somebody in your family or even a stranger force themselves on you and you know you don't want it, mm-hmm. right? It's the same. It's the same with the husband.
So you're saying sex without consent is rape? That's what you're trying to tell me now?
Yes, at least. Type of sexual activity without consent is rape. Whether it be sex, whether it be a kiss, whether it be the hug, a touch, anything. Alright.
Okay, Vinny.
So this whole sexual consent thing different. Let me say now, for example, I'm at the bar. Mm. See this shorty, she come in. Talking to shorty, you know, I'm talking to shorty. She sitting on the stool at the bar. And I just there, you know what I mean? Me touch you, you know. But I just say, yeah, I talk to you, you know, I talk to you.
I don't reach your face.
Okay, I got a consent for you, though. Or that is just okay.
I would think that would be excuse,
since
like the bar is going to be like a noisy.
Yeah, but it should still come out of her face.
Yeah, you need to move.
Yes.
So we go straight into the response from a viewer on Instagram. About what is about their view on sexual consent?
Okay. So what they said was, it goes way beyond simply yes or no. There are gestures and other signals to consider. Many are often misinterpreted, but my position is consent in any form is important.
Same thing as we just said.
Yep.
So do y'all think consent can be withdrawn at any time?
Yes. While it isn't fair, and I do believe it isn't fair, because you know sometimes while having sex, you know, sometimes while having sex, a woman would start, you know, completely in the mood, and then during the event, the man gets so, you know, into it that he starts being more aggressive. Then she's comfortable with, right? And then she's going to say stop or no or something. But he is already in, like, you know, this is how he feels, and he's in the mood. And he does want to stop, but she said no. She said stop.
Right. And some males, when it says stop, they take that as a green light to keep going.
Why are you bashing anyone up on this thing? Because I don't want to say anything and get myself
in. I'm just saying.
Because they're quick to put you on TikTok and where's the other talk? I don't want to be out here, you know. But I just like the viewers to know, we're not no experts in any of this. We're just giving our views because we're trying to give young people a voice in saying things. Because most young people don't really like to talk about sex. Because this show is all about giving young people a voice. Shortly, I'm thinking in my next video, the next two videos to come, we'll be touching abortion. That is a topic that is very touchy. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So, something is it? This is it for today?
Any more responses?
Let me check. By the time y'all keep y'all tune in, we'll get a drawing in a few for a brunch.
Yeah. The Tropical Garden Brunch.
22nd of August.
The 22nd of August, we're giving away. Oh. We're giving away a whole ticket to one lucky winner. So stay tuned for that in a couple of minutes. We don't have any more responses. We have this one that says consent, the importance of consent. How pressuring someone into saying yes, but sure. Isn't consent.
Females is applied pressure, you telling me?
No. Somebody said no and you push them until they say yes.
So what applied pressure nice. Mean? What up? That's what? Not yeah, nice. Explain me what is like applied pressure. Let me go Google this thing, what is applied pressure. I want to know what applied pressure does not mean
to breach someone's boundaries, sir.
I gotta check what applied pressure means. I mean, understand.
In my view, it means like if you and somebody like together,
mm-hmm. or even not, like if you're dating.
Yeah.
All right. Google said this is a. Let's see the Urban Dictionary. Yeah, Urban Dictionary said to overcome an obstacle and excel within fitness and any given task due to an individual. Listen, with power.
Listen. Just because somebody said apply pressure, that don't mean, you know, breach their boundaries. All I'm simply mean is, you know, be a little extra with it. Don't be all this back and
forth. Don't want like the bare minimum.
Exactly.
That's it. Don't be doing like the bare minimum.
Don't be coming all touchy-touchy.
Go out of your way for your girls.
They are. Show appreciation. Simple thing.
Oh my gosh.
They got home.
Yeah.
Being married does not give anyone the. Okay, no, this is cheating. Why do we have?
That's a mixed up, man. It got mixed up. We be touching on cheating. The it got mixed up in the outline. Cheating. That cheating, I think, is the next.
Okay.
Topic that we'll be touching on. Mm-hmm. So we go straight into the drawing now. I think that's it for consent for today.
I got more response. Stop.
Now we go straight into the drawing with the winner of one bowl package for the summertime fine garden brunch on the 22nd of August, which will be hosted by the Big Fox team.
So the question that was asked was who are the hosts for the Big Fat Sock Show, and the winner of that, of the ticket, is Stacia. I guess she came the closest.
Yeah.
Her response was
Venetia, myself, Wallace the photographer guy, and Abu. That was it. That was our exact word. So she came the closest to Oh, actually, she gets everyone right.
She was on point.
So she get depressed. Oh, I must bring her up all the way in Toronto, Canada. Yeah, so station, see you in August. So this is where we take our leave. Peace. Shit, I said Ran. Nah, I was getting the ending now. Peace! Yeah, let's go together. Peace!
Put down your hand.
Put black in my face.
Oh my god.
You had to tell up everybody that out of the lens.
I am new to all this shit, so. Yeah, we're out.